Every now and then you hear about a young athlete who dies suddenly on the athletic field.
The most common cause of that is sudden cardiac death from hypertrophic cardiomyopathy.
Patients with HCM really suffer from the inability to do anything that would put strain on the heart.
It's a thickening of the heart muscle.
Why that led to sudden death was completely unknown.
Nobody knew how to treat this disease or what was behind it.
We identified mutations in myosin that cause hypertrophic cardiomyopathy.
That, for the first time, provided a direct cause of the disease.
Crick discovered that this was a genetic disease, and John helped decode the genetics to figure out which proteins were responsible.
Between us, we feel like our training and background has been very synergistic.
Cricket then built models to understand what was going wrong with the proteins.
And what became evident was that the relaxation capacity of the heart was reduced.
Cricket and John's work pointed us to which proteins to change and how, more importantly, how they needed to be changed in order to correct the underlying defects that caused the disease.
We felt it was essential to move from an academic setting to a collaboration in an industrial setting, a biotech startup.
So we founded a company called MyoKardia in collaboration with two other founders.
So I got involved just as MyoKardia was getting launched.
Bob McDowell took us through the development of this small molecule, without which MyoKardia would not be where it is today.
My goal was to take the findings from Cricket and John's lab and then say, how do we find the right drug candidate that could correct these underlying causes of disease?
We screened lots and lots of molecules.
And that led to discovery of MYK-461, which later became Camzyos. So we entered phase one trials to assess safety. And in the process, we tested a couple of patients who had HCM.
It was remarkable from the very first few patients.
We were ecstatic.
And then we did a phase three study.
We had physicians calling us and saying, our patients were barely able to use a wheelchair, and now they're running on the beach. What's going on here?
We were delighted to see that they found an enormous difference in the patient's symptoms. They were improved. They had less shortness of breath, greater exercise activity.
I still get goosebumps even thinking about that.
Small biotech companies can do small clinical trials, but to try and launch a product, that is very hard to do given the costs.
So Bristol-Myers Squibb made a tender offer to acquire MyoKardia.
And they've carried on doing other clinical trials. Camzyos is currently being used by cardiologists across the country, including my own cardiologist. And Cricket has several patients who are on Camzyos.
It's enormously gratifying to see them feeling well.
They're leading normal lives. They're playing with their grandkids. They're walking on the beach.
That's been just an outstanding feeling.
And it's really what we do this for. We would have never had the idea of how to tackle HCM without the academic work.
It's been an exciting experience, for sure.
That's really the power of a combination of academic, biotech, and big pharma in bringing new hope to lots of patients for lots of diseases.